Alright, so in this video I'm going to go over how to rebuild a piston and cylinder. This saw had a stripped spark plug port, which is right here where the spark plug goes in, is stripped. And this happens when you start a saw with a spark plug that's not screwed on tight all the way, and it'll just rattle around on the inside and then end up stripping that port. There's not much we can do besides, you know, replacing the entire cylinder, basically. Lucky for us, we've got an extra one laying around. This one came off of one that had a destroyed piston, so I'm hoping this will work, but we'll rebuild it and see if it does. I've taken off the muffler, the heat plate, the heat gasket, the original piston and cylinder off of this, and now we're down to just the crankshaft, and I've taken this gasket, cleaned it off, and replaced it. So now we're ready to rebuild. A couple of tools we're gonna need. This is a stand that'll help us with keeping the piston steady, and then also this little clamp that'll close down on the piston rings, which are these guys right here, and allow us to slip the cylinder on top. So first things first, when you get a new piston and cylinder assembly, you'll have this needle bearing that slips on the inside here. But before we do that, we'll use a little bit of two-stroke oil and just get it lubricated. Slip that in there. Now the next two pieces you're gonna have are this piston and this rod. Now on a new piston there's gonna be an arrow that points down the direction of the bar, and so you know how to orient this. If you turn it backwards, I don't think it'll work too well for you. So. But this one's old, so you can't really see the etching on the top. It's kind of charred. But pretty sure it goes on this way. So you want this to sit over this crankshaft right here. And then basically you're going to slip this rod through, but also through here in the crankshaft, so it attaches your piston to your crankshaft. Before I do that, I'm going to lubricate this as well. Just dipped it in some of that two-cycle engine oil. And I'm going to make sure it's lined up. And it should just slide right through, but there we go. So now you can see it's attached to the crankshaft. I've got that rod slipped in, and the next thing we're gonna want to do is slip in this piston ring, and that's basically just gonna hold that rod in place. Now this is a bit of a tricky process. First you want to make sure that that rod is sitting completely in there, all the way in. The piston ring on the other side has already been installed, so you can't push it out in that direction. Now we just need to put this in to keep it from slipping out towards us. So to do this, I take needle nose pliers and just grab it right here by that arm. Make sure that's slipped in right there in the groove. And you kind of want to push in and turn counterclockwise, rotate counterclockwise at the same time. Oops, don't lose that. And there we go. So now you can see in there, we've got the ring sitting inside that groove, and it's going to hold that rod in there so it's not going to slip off. So now you've got your piston installed. Now the next thing you want to do is install your cylinder. This is, again, a reused cylinder. So I've cleaned it off on the inside, gotten any sort of metal shards off. Now we're gonna slip it on top. Before we do that, I'll take some two-cycle engine oil and lubricate the piston. And two things you're gonna want when installing this is the clamp and a rubber mallet. So if you look closely at this piston, there's two little spots where these rings are gonna close in on when you put pressure on. Make sure they're just aligned correctly. Otherwise, they're not gonna wanna close. So once they're aligned correctly, I'll slip this clamp over and just tighten down on it to create a good seal, but give it a little space at the top so that you can slip your cylinder on, right? So make sure your cylinder is also oriented correctly and slip it on and just kind of have it sitting right there. And when it's sitting, I'm gonna take the rubber mallet, just knock on it until it slips over the piston rings. And just like that, I've gone over the seals for the piston. Now I can slip out the clamp and also slip out the stand. And usually I just kind of wiggle it left and right, making sure the gasket is in place. All right, so now I'm still working on getting the cylinder in, and one thing I want to check to make sure is that this port goes inside of this manifold right here. Before I do that, I'm going to need to loosen up this metal band. This band is meant to create a tight seal between the manifold and the cylinder itself. So I'm going to loosen it so that I can slip it through right there. And now that once it's slipped through, I can tighten the band down. All right, so now I've got that band tightened down and I can start slipping these cylinder screws in. To screw those in, you're gonna need a 4mm Allen key. And then make sure you go back through one more time to make sure all of those screws are on tight. There you go. Have a new cylinder installed. Now you're not quite done there yet. There's a couple of other pieces that I've taken off of the old cylinder that I'm gonna put back on the new one. The first is a spark plug. This time I'm gonna screw it on and make sure it's on tight. Oh. So this one came off the old one. I guess the threading on it's stripped, so I'm going to use a new one. So here is a new spark plug. Just gonna screw it on there. It's pretty tight. Make sure we get it on completely with a scrunch. And make sure it's not tight, but don't wrench it on so hard that you end up stripping the threads anyway. Next piece we have here is the decompression valve, and it goes right over the top here. Again, make sure that that is on tight. And finally, you've got this anti-vibration coil. And that's gonna go over here on this side. And the screw that's in it doesn't come out. You just gotta screw it back on. And finally, there's one last piece, this little rubber piece that generally goes over the top here. It's not essential. Basically what it does is keeps you from losing that one cylinder screw right there, and you can pop it on if you like. And there you go. We now have a reassembled piston and cylinder.